surf.
Late July in North Carolina, I'm going to throw some two drop rigs. Throw some 3 and 4 ounce weights, 3 on the smaller rod, 4 on the bigger rod. We're going to use some fish bites and also some shrimp, also some other baits. So we're going to throw some out. Right now it's getting a little late in the morning. I had a late start due to some personal issues. I had to help somebody earlier. So we'll try to get out here fish as long as I can before it gets too crowded on the beach. It's beautiful out here. It's already really hot, and we're going to try to get it in. This first rig out. It's just a little 3 ounce weight on it. A piece of shrimp and a piece of bloodworm fish bite. This one's going to say a little more shallow. This is the 9 foot Triumph, St. Croix Triumph, matched with the Stratic 5000. Okay, it's nice. The water's pretty warm, probably like low 80s right now. All right, we'll throw the other one out. A little bit of a heavier weight on it. A little bigger. These have size 6 hooks on them, real small. I'm just gonna try to catch some whiting on this guy, hopefully. Another one I'll throw a little deeper at. The water's pretty blue. Looks fairly clear. The sun's coming up still, as you see here. I still the other one out. Okay, this one has 4 ounce weight on it, and it has size 3 odd hooks on it. Let's see, this is, I think that's fine. Let's check that one, make sure it's not going to drag in front of me. All right, we'll throw this one out now. Let's try to throw this a little deeper, maybe. This is the star rod, I think it's 9 something foot, and this matched with the guy with BG 4500. It has 30 pound braid on it also. Actually, the other one has 20 pound braid. I thought it was. Yeah, I knew my line was running down the beach. Hope you're a lucky day. There's a nice size one for here. Alright, let's measure them. I knew it was something on there. A spotted crab. It's pregnant, so let's get it back out. I like to loosen the drag a little bit so they don't pop out. Alright. Yeah, I keep the drag a little looser than normally would if I'm holding it. So I don't want them to pop out of the sand spike or drag over in the sand. Sometimes I pull out, especially if you get a bigger fish. Pelicans flying over there. Whew, it's hot already. Jeez. Oh, Dominus. I'm back out here on the beach. It's the next day. Yesterday wasn't too good. I fish about 2-3 hours. 3 hours, and I caught one nice size pompano. But I put it back because I was the only one I caught. So I'm going to throw out this 4 ounce weight and a 3 ounce weight on this guy, this smaller rig, with some sand fleas, some shrimp, and some fish bites. Both set up with the same type of two drop. This has, I think, 3 odd hooks on it, and this one has size 6 hooks on it. Smaller hooks and a smaller setup, lighter setup. So we're going to keep this a little more shallow maybe, and this one a little deeper. See if you can get something to bite. All right, we're going to start. hear it, but I don't see it. Let's get you free. His name is Stinger, maybe because he's gone. Okay, so the bite is on here. Every time I throw it out, I'm getting hit.
They're little fish. They're stealing my bait, but unfortunately, they will. So yeah, I'm only throwing one at a time. Because every time I throw it out, I'm getting hit. Every time I bring one in, the other one's getting off. They're little white, I'm assuming.
But the bite is definitely on right now. Sure, this is a croaker. I set the hook this time. Let's see if it stays on.
stingray. And they might have got off again. Damn it. Can't tell. There's something on, looks like. Oh, yeah, tiny little fish. That's a little pinfish. Smaller and smaller. Size croaker.
What do you have, man?
Oh, you're a cat. It's a cat.
Hope there's some pompano. The line dig a little slack. It's definitely fighting a little bit. Could be a whiting. This rod's real sensitive, so it feels bigger than it probably is. Could be another big pinfish. Biggest pinfish ever, or spot. I thought they were spot, they could be big giant pinfish. Bit.